Wildhearts is another game that was set up for failure by EA, notoriously known for killing off their games, and in today's video, I'm going to tell you why. It's one of the many games released last year that needed more time to bake in the oven. Unfortunately, it seems EA set up this game to have a bad running start, especially with how jam-packed it has been for releases. Being on top of your game with a polished release last year was important, making sure you iron out as many issues as possible before it hits the shelf for release. Meanwhile, we've seen a lot of different companies lay off people in 2023 and this year. From EA, Unity, BioWare, Bungie, Ascendant Studios, and Epic Games to name a few. The gaming industry itself seems anything but stable when it comes to job security. Regardless of how anyone may feel, it's individuals that make up these games you and I play. Everyone has bills to pay and families to feed, so it's unfortunate when you come across news like this. The industry can be cruel to developers, whether they do well or not, and by extension, future games and unique ideas suffer. I wanted to love Wildhearts when it first came out back in February, but if you're like me and play a variety of games, there's been a lot that has dropped, taking up our time. For as many solid releases we had in 2023, there's been just as many unoptimized and buggy games.
No, not him!
I'm seeing freaking dragons, and oh yeah, I'm talking to a cop! I just moved it with my freaking mind!
No one is coming to help you.
Back around April last year, EA offered a demo for this game you could try, so of course, I did. I played and streamed the demo for about 3 hours, and during this time, I had experienced frame drops, texture pop-ins, and other technical issues. It actually gave me a headache. I ended the stream soon after. I'm not even exaggerating. The performance made me feel
so much pain! So much pain!
However, despite that, I saw potential in what I had experienced and hoped it would be improved at the full release. Now fast forward to when this game launched mid-February. I quickly signed up to get the EA Pro Pass, which is similar to Microsoft's Game Pass, which allows you to play their respective library for a price. You do not own these games, but renting them. I was skeptical after my experience during the PC Early Access demo, but went into it cautiously optimistic. Much to my disappointment, I didn't see much of an improvement from that. I wanted to love and continue to play this game. I really did, but it was a game I quickly dropped due to the numerous performance issues and poor optimization I experienced with my 3060 and Ryzen 5900X. The state it was in was unacceptable and quickly moved on to playing Atomic Hearts, which had its own set of problems, but I digress. Meanwhile, others with high-end GPUs couldn't even hit a steady 60 FPS. That should tell you all you needed to know. Looking at the online sentiment at the time, and even now, the issues are still sadly presented. This was released as an EA original title, where the developer still owns the IP and the game, but EA would help fund and publish it. Koei Tecmo and their internal team, Omega Force, developed this. It seems like sometimes consumers don't understand how these agreements can work and are quick to blame developers. Not to say that it can't be the case sometimes, whether it's one side or the other or both, but patches cost money to roll out and go through a certification process before it goes live. That's why PC rollouts for patches is often first, because the process is different from what Sony and Microsoft have in place. But who really knows at the end of the day while Wildhearts was in the state at release? Profits versus the quality of a product, where appeasing the stockholder takes more priority than the art and care a developer may have for their game. Similar to Monster Hunter, this game is not required to have an internet connection to play, but it's hard to enjoy when the game has all these different performance issues, and that's not even getting into the gameplay or other aspects itself. Maybe there's a chance it will get support if it does well on the Game Pass, but I highly doubt it. At the time of this recording, this is the player base on Steam that remains for this game. Not sure on what those Game Pass numbers look like. Since it's been brought to the Game Pass, I figured I'd give it a try again, since I thought there were some unique takes and ideas compared to Monster Hunter. So for one, the Katakuri in this game can be used for a multitude of things, whether it was in combat, placing blocks down that consume up thread for boosts, aerial combat with special moves you can pull off, or for evasive maneuverability. It's up to you how you want to use it. In any given situations, there are other katakuri like placing down a tent you can rest in or combining different ones together for a unique one. While there aren't as many weapon type as Monster Hunter having 14, I think Wildhearts make up for how creative each weapon is. There are 8 types in this game, but each weapon has multiple combo strings between standard and special attacks, and special attacks being unique to each weapon that you can utilize. In the demo, I recall these little balls I found called Tsukumo, scattered all throughout the map you can find that assists you. They have different forms from attack, defense, assist, and threader, as well increase your thread count for when you use Katakuri. These to me are your Palico equivalent, although not as cute. The small kimono or monsters, you can either kill or pet them by sneaking up, which you can end up harvesting different resources from them, which I don't think I've seen in any other game before like this, aka Monster Hunter. Then there's weapon sharpening. In Wildhearts, you don't have to worry about maintaining your weapon sharpness like you would in Monster Hunter, whereas you land attacks, the duller the weapons you use would get, resulting in dealing less damage, and depending on the monster you're fighting, you also risk bouncing off of them too. I wanted Monster Hunter to have competition as it breeds innovation, but there's nothing on the market even close to Wildhearts in my opinion. For now, Monster Hunter remains undefeated. I love Monster Hunter and have been playing since Monster Hunter Tri and onwards. It's safe to say that I have over thousands of hours on this beloved series alone, so I don't want anyone to think I hate Monster Hunter. It's far from it. It's just that I wanted to see more games of this type and from a fresh pair of eyes. That's what I thought, hoped, Wildhearts was going to be. Since it's brought so many new and innovative ideas that were different than what we've seen from Monster Hunter, I wanted this game to succeed. Much like FromSoft being the pioneers and others that took inspiration from what they've created. NeoWiz with Lies of P, Gunfire with Remnant, and CI Games with Lords of the Fallen. Whether you're a fan or not of these kind of games, they each offer unique twists on the Souls-like subgenre, similar but different. Back in September, news and articles started to circulate around a Reddit leak. In this, the following was posted. What you think has happened to the game has unfortunately happened. In typical EA news, it seems like they did not want to sit on the game and give it the time and expect it to be most likely be the next Monster Hunter. Seems like it didn't turn into the multi-million dollar big hit they wanted and don't want to give it the love to grow. Some of you here who are in the Discord will know who I am as a mod, and others will not know who I am, wondering probably who my sources are. But yes, the obvious is obvious. It's really unfortunate the game isn't getting the support it needed. Look what happened to Titanfall 2. It was Respawn's original IP, which would have been potentially a big competitor to Call of Duty during its futuristic cycle. EA gave no marketing or proper support during its lifetime, causing the IP to fail. Fortunately, Respawn got their second chance at it with Apex Legends, which brought some of the original ideas back with it existing in the Titanfall universe. But who knows if Wildhearts will get that same opportunity. EA was probably wanting or expecting and thought Wildhearts would be successful like Capcom's Monster Hunter from the jump. Since both games share similarities, at its core, both are action RPGs where you, the protagonist, hunt down monsters, craft and upgrade your weapons to fight even bigger monsters with bigger weapons. I was rooting for its success, but it didn't get a chance, a fair chance at that. It's a brand new IP versus Capcom's Monster Hunter that's been out for close to 2 decades. It had time to cement its place and establish its fan base. EA needs time to lay a solid foundation. It's not something that just happens overnight. I mean, just look at Lies of P. It's a great example of developers who understand the intricacies and design philosophy of what makes FromSoft's Souls game as successful as they are. We have, in my opinion, the best Souls-like to date. If you're curious to hear more of my thoughts on Lies of P, link will be at the end of this video and in the description box for you to check out. It's a refreshing experience as you go through the game. While many others have attempted to get the recipe down and can't seem to get it quite right, whether it's the combat, the enemies, level design, there's always that something that's missing. Going back to it, at the end of the day, look, I get it. It's a business. If it's not profitable, why continue to sink money into it? But I can't help but wonder and wish if they just gave it more time, perhaps things would have been different with the game. If you made it to the end of this video, thanks for listening to my disappointment on what happened with Wildhearts. Leave a not again with your comment. Let me know what are your thoughts are on the game, and while you're at it, subscribe to the channel for more content. Thanks for watching.